Hello， 大家好，我是亚洲老大的珍妮。九的三次方是多少呢？你是否也可以不用计算机解答呢？很多人都知道印度人的数学普遍都非常好，到底有多好呢？让我们到孟买的街道看看，一般人的数学是否都真的那么厉害吧。
So, a BBC report stated that an Indian bride walked out of the wedding after the groom failed to solve 15 plus 6. How do you feel about this?
Good thing she did. It's actually easy.
Perfect, that's like basic knowledge. Anyone should get to know how to add 15 and 6. All the best to her. Yeah, get a better groom, please.
Shameful. I mean, if I can't do it, I'll be okay if someone walks out on me as well. Like, it's such a stupid thing not to...I mean, if you can't solve 15 plus 6, then you're stupid. Then nobody deserves you.
I feel bad. I obviously feel bad because... see, marriage is not something, you know, two people connect not because of their intelligence. The heart should be connected, I feel.
If this was an incident in the rural India,
yeah.
Specifically in the areas like Haryana and that sort of place.
Okay.
So yeah, being good at mathematics and sciences is a matter of pride over there.Like relatives will come to your house instead of asking, hey, how you're doing in life, how comfortable are you, like what do you want? They will ask you mathematical tables and stuff like that just to prove themselves, make you feel small or like check you out.
Globally, Indians are known for being good at math. Do you think this is true?
I don't think that's true, but for some specific cases, it could be true.
Yeah, it is true.
Yeah, I guess in a way, it is a little bit true.The way that we taught math is different than the way, I guess, other countries do.
It doesn't stand for everyone, you see. We have a huge diversity in terms of that, and not everyone can be good in maths. That's a wrong conception if you have that.
That's because we have a lot of maths from childhood. We don't depend on calculators. We don't depend on computers so much. So definitely they are better at numbers.
In a scale of 1 to 10, how good would you say you are in math?
1.
7.
7. Okay. How much do you usually score?
Above 90.
Actually, I'm really bad.I wouldn't say anything, you can say 2 or 3.
I'm going to ask you a couple of math questions, okay? Try your best to answer them, right? What is 87 plus 87?
174.
What is 87 plus 87?
174.
12 into 14?
168.
No.
No? Okay. What is the square of 18?
324.
What is the square of 18?
324.
It's fine. You can take it.
326.
You are there. 324. What is the square of 18?
324.
That's true. Cube of 9. 9
and 81. 721, something like that.
729.
729, yeah.
What is the cube of 9?
729.
Yeah. What is the root of 256?
16.
Yes. What is the square of 12?
144.
Okay. And he says that I'm not good at math. What is the cube of 9?
90. 729.
That's true. Root of 256?
Uh-huh. 7,
7, 4, 9,
16.
That's true. What is the cube of 9? 729. That's right. What is the root of 256?
16.
What is the root of 256?
16.
16 is true. Okay. So how were those questions, easy or difficult for you?
They were okay. I mean, they were not too hard.These kind of math problems are actually easy for Asians, I think.
India seems to have a unique way of calculating big numbers in their head and with their fingers. Could you show me how to do it?
So you have like 4 divisions in each of your fingers.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. 4 in each. So you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it goes till 20. 5 into 4, 20. So that way you keep counting. If you have to add something, suppose 8 and 4, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.And you have to add 4 more, so 1, 2, 3, 4, that gives you a 12.
How did you do the first one, 87 plus 87? How did you do that?
80 plus 80, that's 160, and then 7 plus 7, 14.
Okay, so there you go.
Just add both of them up, yeah.
There is more than one way to solve a question, a particular question. And
those ways are not just told by our teachers or ourselves discover some ways to solve a particular question.
Do students use calculators in school in India?
No. No, no calculators.
So, I know that for a fact in universally, I'm pretty sure most of the countries they allow, Western education allows calculators, but in India, like even right now in college and even for the entrance exams and stuff, you have no access to calculators, whether it's derivatives, integration, nothing. So, yeah.
Do you think that the Indian society has high standards for the general public on math?
Yeah. I think Indians are expected to know quite a, like mental maths and stuff pretty well. Even if you're in a corporate, if you're working in an office or something, like there are some things that people expect you to know without taking the, to calculate without using a calculator, basically. Yeah.
It does because, see, this is the land where zero was discovered, okay? So it is intrinsically in our brains that we are good at maths and plus accounting concepts, everything was developed in India. So it's a basic understanding with all Indians have in their mind that you should be good in maths.
When you're going to the government schools, you'll have below average English teachers, below average social science teachers, but you'll have all right maths teachers. So naturally your expectations for mathematics grows from there only.
If you consider Indian parents, which is the Desi parents, then yes, they do actually. I mean, I scored 82 or 100 on math in math, which I think is pretty good, but my parents were not happy at all.
What would you like to say to people overseas who have these stereotypes about India?
Not all of us are good at math, but quite a few are. So that's it. I mean, there are quite a few things they all are good at too. The only thing I'd say is the fact that they do not allow children to rely on calculators is like the biggest thing, because that really does help in the future. If you don't need to, you don't have the urge to take a calculator out and you're able to do stuff on your own.
To be very honest, I myself want to know and research about that why is this, that why is this stereotypical image that we Indians are only good at maths and why not the outsiders one?
Okay.
Don't have the stereotype in their minds that only Indians are good at maths. It depends only on the person.
It is actually the social pressure due to which the perception is that majority of the Indians are good at mathematics. Actually, the natural capability is, I believe, the same all over the world. It's a socio-cultural phenomenon over here which promotes mathematics in a way, and you see the result.
这次的访谈是否改变了你对印度人算术能力的看法呢？也欢迎留言分享你的意见。如果想了解更多亚洲新闻和文化动向，你就请记得关注我们的频道。谢谢收看，还要记得求知若渴。